Today's video is sponsored by Roborock.
Oh, hey.
Hey, how's it going?
That's good. Paper plate, speaker, boombox?
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
Cool.
Previously on the channel, we have made paper plate speakers, but today we want to upgrade that into a whole surround sound paper plate speaker system.
We've got lots of different plates, sizes, and types. We've got the magnets, wire, glue, everything that we should need to make this paper surround sound system. I think we need to start building speakers. Well, let's take a quick look at what it takes to make a speaker. How does the electric current get turned into sound?
It's actually pretty interesting how simple it is to make a speaker and how simple the system actually is. So for ours, all you need is a plate, some 28 gauged wire or 30, depending on how you're really feeling, and some magnets.
Depending on how you're feeling. The gauge of the wire isn't strictly important. You can make a speaker using other gauges. This is just a good thin gauge that lets us wrap easily without adding too much weight or electrical resistance.
Because the wrap is actually one of the most important pieces between the magnet size and its power and how many wraps you get.
We've got a few different types and sizes of magnets. We've got some of these cheap ceramic ones that really don't have very much power. We've got some of these middle-sized neodymium magnets that are pretty good. Grace is holding
our chonky guy,
our largest magnet. So I'm gonna try and make a speaker that uses one of this size, and to help me with that, I have a steel rod that I just got at Home Depot that is basically the exact same size as my magnet here. And so I'm gonna do all of my wrap on the steel bar, and then it should fit over my magnet. And part of the reason I'm doing that is this magnet is small enough that like working on the magnet itself is just a little inconvenient. I'm going to start by cutting off a couple of strips of paper. It's about an inch and a half wide right now. I'll end up trimming it down smaller.
I'm gonna use our much weaker ceramic magnets that you can literally get from anywhere and start that process.
So I'm going to start by taking this piece of printer paper and maybe giving it about two wraps around this steel bar. With that first wrap complete, I now want to do a second layer around that first layer. And that first layer is going to act as a spacer. It's just there to create a gap between the size of the second layer and the bar itself. So my next step is to get some of this enamel coated wire. So this is copper wire that's been painted red, and that paint lets you see the wire better, but also it's not electrically conductive. So if the wire is touching itself, it's not going to send electricity across the point where they're touching. And that's important because we're gonna wrap it, it's gonna be touching itself a lot, but all of that electricity is going to have to go all the way around through the wire. It can't go in and then jump from wire to wire across to shortcut it. It's gotta just go in all the circles. We need those circles. So I've given myself what is certainly extra wire here, but I'm just leaving several inches off to the side, and I'm going to start getting a wrap around, and I'm gonna use a single dot of hot glue to hold the wire in place. And we want to get probably at least 50, maybe 70 wraps around. And 70. I got a layer of hot glue to hold all the wire in place, but I'm also going to do just a layer of super glue because the hot glue occasionally can come unstuck from the wires, whereas the super glue is going to get down in between them. And once it dries, it should hold them better than the hot glue. And then I want to remove the inner layer. I don't want both of those paper wraps, just the one. We can make some pretty cool speaker-like shapes when we use these styrofoam bowls. So I'm gonna do that and try and turn this into a shape that lets our paper plate speaker cone fit nicely on top of here. Now I need to secure the magnet down in place to the bottom of this styrofoam bowl speaker body. With the magnet secured onto this piece, I need to take our little wire wrap and secure it onto the other side, the plate that is going to be the cone that actually creates the sound. At this point, if we fit our paper cylinder over the magnet, the paper can rest all the way down to the bottom of our styrofoam bowl, and that's not quite what we want. We're going to want to hold it up so that the wire wrap just slightly overlaps the top edge of the magnet. So we're going to make some paper springs that keep our plate suspended at just the point where we want it.
The last thing you have to do is burn off the enamel coating on the end of these to expose the copper wire.
Or if you have some really fine sandpaper, you can also sand it off. I'd say it's about as loud as a pair of earbuds.
Look at the little plate job.
Okay, so my magnets are way weaker than Nate's. There is sound coming from this little guy. It's doing it. It's weak, but it's there. So, shall we get out the amp?
I think we need to crank this up. Literally, crank it up.
Literally.
When we were plugging directly into the phone, it was only sending out the amount of power that a phone uses to drive headphones. So while there was sound, it wasn't very much. Now,
not at all.
We're gonna be sending the sound through an amplifier, which, as the name implies, amplifies what's coming in. This adds power. There's more electricity to go in through the coil that we've built than there was just from the little bit of power coming out of a phone. Let's see what the difference sounds like.
Oh, immediately, it's like so good.
So there's a lot of bass on this, in parts of this song. Oh geez, this is gonna go off when it's bass. Oh, it literally just popped off the magnet.
My guy's turn. All right, here go our really, really crappy ceramic magnets. All right, let's give it a go. So this guy averages like 60 and 70.
Like before, when you first tried it, you had to like almost have your ear
touching it, on it basically.
To hear anything at all.
This is an improvement.
Definitely.
But we are definitely not using these magnets.
The neodymium magnets.
For this project.
Way better for this.
So we have like 10 one-inch why can't I say this word? Neodymium?
Neodymium.
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 Dymium. Neodymium. Okay. We ordered a bunch of 1-inch neodymium magnets, and then we have the rest of the ones that we used to prototype, which still give really good sound. So from here, we just build a bunch of them, and then we're gonna put them on the wall and have a whole surround sound speaker system that's also Bluetooth. It's gonna be super rad. Okay, so our bigger magnets finally came in, and these suckers are so strong. So we need to get making some speakers out of these guys and our other smaller guys too.
While Grace was finishing up the plates for the wall, I went ahead and I made a boombox made of paper, plate, speakers, and cardboard with some fun little decorative lighting elements on the side. Too much. Well, there you go. A Bluetooth speaker made to look like a boombox that is made of cardboard, paper, and a lot of hot glue. That's pretty cool. Let's see how Grace is doing on those paper plates for the wall.
This is it!
Not bad. We've got, 16 speakers going?
Yeah, something like that. Ignore the fancy wires.
Per side. Yeah, we did a really careful job with the wiring here.
But they're all connected!
Avant-garde art style. Yes, they are all wired. We've got left channel sound and right channel sound, or maybe we have them backwards, I'm not sure. We're mostly playing just a music song that's not terribly mixed for back and forth, so it shouldn't make too much difference. But in theory, we should have all the speakers playing right now. Give it a test. Let's do this. I'm hearing it. It's coming through.
Look at it. That's all of them. My favorite part about this project is that we didn't have to do any of the floor cleanup. Our Roborock S7 did it all for us. It has sonic mapping technology that scrubs floors up to 3,000 times per minute. Roborock uses ultrasonic sound to detect carpet. The intelligent mop actually lifts to avoid mopping the carpet, and it lifts also when it's done, so there's no dirty streaks. The all-new rubber brush agitates more efficiently and is even better at avoiding hair tangles. Roborock has precision floor navigation. It maps out your house up to 4 levels. You can schedule cleanings for different times of the day, as well as specific rooms. The coolest features are that you set no-go zones for the Roborock to avoid and it even uses Alexa to control cleanings. The Roborock dock automatically empties the dust bag, making cleaning even easier. Also, the 3-liter dust bag self-seals when removed to prevent dust leaks. Roborock is having the largest sale of the year. The S7 is 30% off and the S7 Plus is 24% off. Honestly, this is the best gift for the holiday season, and you can get yours in the link in our description.
You know what? Mine's being made with love.
That's important.
My hand is cramping.
It's pretty fun
with
to
a piece of paper plate. Like, this has been so much fun, like, yeah. Prototyping and building. And then, like, all of a sudden you get sound and you're like,
what?
Whoa.